water. It is, thank you.
Wow, you're a good man.
I left the last minute, huh? It is May 23rd. This is the Barnstable County Regional Government Board of Regional Commissioners. Again, it is May 23rd. The agenda was posted for 10 a.m. It is 10:04 as the big clock on the wall. And we are located at the County Commissioners meeting room at the Superior Courthouse at 3195 Main Street in Barnstable, Massachusetts. And I'm officially calling the meeting to order. Would you all please join me and arise to go to the Pledge of Allegiance?
I pledge allegiance to the flag of the United States of America and to the republic for which it stands, one nation under God, indivisible, with liberty and justice for all.
If you could all please remain standing just for a quick moment of silence for those that have died in the service of our country and those that are presently serving our country. Okay, thank you all very much. So we don't hear barking dogs and quacking ducks, so I'll make sure I shut off my phones. Sorry, I'm running a little late this morning, so trying to get my stuff together. First of all, is there any members of the public here that may be either taping the meeting or audio or videotaping it? I don't even see any members of the public here. So let's go right down to public comment. There are no members of the public here, so some room is filled with staff, and I'm sure they'll be coming up as we go down through the agenda. So the first thing I have is the approval of the minutes. We have 2 minutes on the agenda today. I'm going to take May 9th first. I'm looking for someone to move to approve the regular session meeting minutes of May 9th, 2018, as presented.
So moved.
Second.
It's been moved and seconded. Any questions on those? I had some corrections, but they were done prior to approving them. So
I had some as well, and
yep, minor stuff.
Probably the same already? Thing.
Yep. All in favor?
Aye.
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 Just make this. Okay, that brings us to item B, which is the minutes of May 16th, 2018. I'm looking for someone to approve the regular meeting minutes of May 16th, 2018, as presented.
So moved.
Second.
Been moved and seconded. Any questions or corrections on those? Hearing none, all those in favor?
Aye.
Aye. Aye.
Okay, that brings us to general business, which is 6 on the agenda. And the first thing we have up is the draft proposal for Ordinance 18-2 to be numbered Barnstable County Coastal Resource Committee. I see we have some members of the Cape Cod Commission here. I first of all just want to apologize that this is something that I've been working on for a while. It's just been really crazy, and between my own farm and trying to get up and running because of the spring and trying to get our thoughts together from that meeting that was held on March 20th. This is the document that I have brought forward. There's a couple of things that I want to point out in it. And my reasons for putting this on the agenda today is so that we can begin moving this process forward first and foremost. We discussed most of the things in this document, but there are some things that I would really like clarified and agreed on by the consensus of the board. I won't be looking for motions or anything, but I'll just take a feeling of the consensus of the board. First and foremost is the name. The Cape Cod Regional Coastal Committee, if you notice on the first paragraph, that was a name that was floated around originally. I personally would rather see, and if you go to the next page, page 2, you'll see Barnstable County Coastal Zone Management Committee. I like that language a little better. The reason why is I don't think there's any confusion on its either doing away with or superseding or in conflict with the current coastal, regional coastal committee that we have in place, number one. Number two, I have a problem not using the term Cape Cod when we are Barnstable County and this is a Barnstable County committee. So if, that's the first part I'd like to discuss is what do we want to name this committee? I particularly like Barnstable County,
Coastal Zone.
Right, Barnstable County Coastal Zone Management Committee.
I like it.
Top of the second page.
I like it, too.
Cape Cod Commission staff, anybody have a problem with that? It's kind of long, but I think it kind of encompasses that what we're trying to do here. We're trying to be a coastal zone management committee, too. We're actually trying to manage and help manage coastal zone issues.
Yeah, I think we agree with the intent. It's more just that you might want to check with the actual CZM, the Coastal Zone Management, and make sure that they're comfortable with the overlap in naming.
Okay. Well, again, that's why we specified it as Barnstable County, you know. But okay, you know something? I jumped ahead here. Can I just ask the indulgence of my board for 1 minute? Did you have time to, did you want me to take something out of the agenda?
Just a little bit earlier up on it, that's all.
This is going to take a little while. Do you want to do yours right now to get you out of here?
Well, all it was those forms. If you're okay with signing those the way they are, that's fine.
I don't think there'd be a problem to do that so
then,
that you won't have to stay around.
Then
I'm
going
to amend the motion to just read that we will be signing specifically the SF 424 and 424D today.
Yes.
And then I'll be scheduling a presentation for the full, what do you call it?
Consolidated plan.
Yeah. So,
sounds good.
Okay, if you want to hang around, fine, but if you want, I can take it out of the agenda now, but
yeah, if you want, just take it out now, and then we'll read.
Okay, can I put this discussion on the proposed ordinance on hold right for now? And can I just ask the indulgence of my committee to make a motion that we take a specific item out of the agenda because we have a staff member that needs to be elsewhere? And it would be item number J, 8J, which is the authorization and execution of the home program. So
I mean, I'm definitely willing to give you a quick little something right now if you want.
I'd rather not today because we got a lot on the agenda.
Okay. All right. So you'll sign those forms today. So
well, I'm going to ask right now if there's okay. any problems with it because I'm going to take 8J out of.
You're removing it completely from
no,
the agenda
I'm
for
No, I'm taking
today?
Yeah. out of context, and we're going to go to it right now for a vote. And then we're going to go back to the one we were discussing, because the staff member has to leave.
Okay.
Does anyone have a question, a problem with the authorization and execution of the home program? I'm going to actually put a motion on the table for 8J, and I'm going to move to authorize the chair to execute the SF-424 and SF-424D forms for the Home Program 2018 Annual Plan documents as presented.
Yeah, for discussion,
right.
Someone.
Thanks.
Second.
Okay. And we have a member of the staff here. This is why I'm taking it out, because she won't be here. Do you want to, do you have any quick questions on this? It's also my intentions to bring staff back and do a presentation of the 2018 annual plan, but these particular forms need to be signed today because of the grant requirements.
So, you meant there. So, do they have to be signed by all of us, or can they just be
just
signed
the
by
chair?
You? Okay. Okay. Good enough.
Okay.
But I'm happy to answer any questions.
Right.
Well, if you're coming back,
question.
Well, she'll come back for a full presentation. But on this, sure.
What? Just have one question. Does it include any funding?
Oh, well, actually, what this is what signs off on our annual plan, so we'll get the funding for 2018, which has been increased, if I could just add that a little bit, that we did get an increase in the home allocation this year.
Sure. Okay.
Up to $87,000. So, yes, this will be the what gets
that
sent to HUD.
This includes funding. Yeah.
Right.
Yes, and it will give us
we'll be getting funding. It doesn't cost us money. This is for us to get
that's
funding.
That's right.
Okay.
It's part of the CON plan, which is the bigger one that I'll do the presentation on.
Great. All right, thank you. I'm going to put this to a vote then. All those in favor?
Aye.
Aye.
Okay, thank you.
Thank you.
I appreciate it. Thank you for, I wish I had taken it out of when I started this, but I'm not having a good day today. That brings us back to, again, the discussion, which is the general business for the ordinance that we were discussing. Thank you again for letting me take that out of contents. All right. The whereas is a pretty simple, basically, if anyone wants to, you could take this document home and make some corrections on it and get back to me if you want to change some of the whereases. The Bonneville County hereby ordains, and this is just the language that we use to create the, and we're going to use the new name for now, so that one's fine. And then basically, section one, it basically just, again, bulletproof language says that we're creating the Bonneville County Coastal Zone Management Committee to establish as part of Bonneville County government. To subject to rules and regulations and administration from budgetary processes. This is kind of bulletproof language that we use in all these committees. The mission, you may just want to take a look at the mission, if there's something you want to add in there, but the planning of the sifting seashore, which is important, planning and enhancing of the shellfish, coastal habitats, identification and education for the public, providing guidance on the dredge, which I think is really important, coordinating regional management, protecting marine estuaries, and again, if you have something you want to add to that, I don't have a problem with adding something. Functions, most of this stuff is pretty much bulletproof language. The functions just kind of coincide with what the State Coastal Zone Management Committee does. This will be our local one. Probably the most important one would be H, would say develop bylaws, and the conduct of businesses approved by the commissioners. I mean, we don't have any policing authority as a county, but some of these bylaws might be something that we can work through the Cape Cod Commission to be a draft bylaws where towns can adopt them or communities can adopt them, kind of basically what we do. Probably the page that I would ask that you help me out with the most would be page 4. And again, this is because you really got to take your thinking cap on here and figure this out. I did not want a committee of a lot of members. I settled in on 9 with 2 additional ex officio members. Now, I go on to explain that those 2 members under C will be a representative of the county commissioners and a representative of the assembly of delegates. So there's 9 voting members, and then included in C would be either one of us or our representative or somebody from the assembly of delegates or their representative. So we have the assembly and we have the commissioners covered. We still have 9 members.
And the ex officio are or are not voting members?
No. They're not.
Okay.
The B just describes a area that the commissioners should look at in making up those 9 members. It's wordy, it's long, I'm not even sure if it really needs to be in there, but I think for a reference point to show that we're doing our due diligence in creating this committee, I left it in.
Which one now?
Would be B.
B?
Yep, 3B. It just kind of describes the areas that we should be looking to get people to come in from.
Okay.
Now when you jump down to D, I covered the fact that of the 9, and this is where I need some discussion. I would like to see either the executive director of the Cape Cod Commission and the executive director of the Cape Cod Cooperative Extension or their designees. The discussion is, are they part of the 9 or do we make 4 more ex officio members? And I did this late last night, so. With the help of, by the way, commission staff helped me quite a bit on this, but I was up quite late trying to work out some better language.
Question?
Yeah.
The ex officio members, how many are there?
Well, that's just what we're 2? Discussing right now. In this plan, there's only 2.
Right now, there's one.
There's just 2. One from the Bonneville County Commissioners and one from the Assembly.
Okay.
Now, if you want the Cape Cod Commission and the Cooperative Extension directors or their designee to be voting members, then you don't have to do anything with this document. Do you guys think you guys should be voting members?
I think that's how we thought of it initially.
Okay,
it
good.
It makes sense to be have the 2.
Because that's the way I have it in here.
Part of the 9.
Right, okay.
So part of the 9?
Yeah. All right, so that's the way it's in there. Then it says members shall have an understanding of coastal resource management, including, I don't really need that in there because B describes that. So D is, I mean, E is kind of overkill.
So you want to cut it out?
We can leave it in. It doesn't matter, but, you know. Barnstable County Social Solicitor Members, it refers to B again. Members appointed by Barnstable Commissioners considered non-binding nominee can enter representative bodies. 3B, appointments for pool nominations. Will those all go back to who now the remaining seven? Because remember, we have, out of the nine, we've already designated two. So we only have seven now to deal with. The committee shall be staggered terms, a majority voting, and then at the first meeting, they're going to elect a...
Quick question.
Yep.
So on H, should we just take out CCRC and put in the BCZZ?
Oh, yeah, absolutely. I have to do that, yeah. I've done that in most places, but... Okay. Here comes the interesting part now, and that's the subcommittees. What I've tried to establish here is that we still want the Barnstable County Coastal Resource Committee that exists today, the one that has 15 members from each town, the one that I cannot find any ordinance that created them or any... There's some documents floating out there, but there's no really ordinance that created them. If we adopt this, that 15-member committee becomes a subcommittee of the Barnstable County Coastal Zone Management Committee. So we are, in essence, codifying, if you will, their existence.
Right.
So I did put a section in here referring to subcommittees, and I only mentioned two. One will be the Barnstable County Coastal Zone Resource Committee, and the other is the Barnstable County Dredge Subcommittee. And if you notice in here, it says presently known as the Dredge Committee. The Dredge Committee is another one. There is no ordinance that created them. They are made up of members of the 15 communities. Most of them are harbor masters who aid us in deciding where the dredge goes next. This action is going to codify that committee.
Yeah, that's a good idea.
And make them a subcommittee of the Barnstable County Coastal Zone Management Committee. So, because... Yeah.
Well, how would the roles differ? I mean, wouldn't we have to have a mission statement and some kind of direction as to what...
That's what I'm hoping is going to come out of this if we vote this, because the 15-member, let's talk about the Dredge Committee right now. The Dredge Committee, I'm not sure what, in their minds, they think they have authority over or not over. I think they believe that they're the ones that determine where the dredge goes and where it doesn't go and what job it does next, and basically that's not really the case.
They're more of an ad hoc committee.
They're more of yes, and they help with putting the process together. So I think once we establish this, my goal is to then have their missions a little bit clearly defined and how they would work together. So without, again, we certainly feel that we don't want to do away with them. We want them around, but making them a subcommittee of this, I just think would be a better way of handling it.
It legitimizes things.
Right. And the way, if you just give me a second, because I think I'm going to answer where you're going, Commissioner Flynn, is if you look at A, specifically the Coastal Resource Subcommittee, right, that's already in existence, but now it's going to be a technical subcommittee with representation from 15 towns, like it is. They are nominated by their selectmen or town council, which they do right now, and two members nominated from the Barnstable County Coastal Zone Management Board. So of the seven that we are discussing, two of them, because remember there's only seven left, we've designated, out of the nine, we've designated one being Cape Cod Commission, one being the Extension Service. So out of the seven, two of them are going to also serve on this subcommittee. So, and all of them are appointed by the county commissioners.
Yeah.
So this makes the subcommittee truly a part of the main committee.
And they'll, after all, They have to get their act together with open meeting law requirements and all that.
Absolutely, yeah. The same thing with the dredge committee. Currently, the dredge committee does exist, and I just outlined in this that the staff has qualified representation nominated by the selectmen of the town council, which they do. I'm not even sure they do that, so this kind of codifies that they should. And again, two members of this new board are also going to serve on the dredge subcommittee. Now, obviously, we're going to, and I didn't want to word this up more because, as you know, I tend to get wordy. Right now, we have a coastal resource committee. We're probably going to take two members from there and make them part of the new committee that we are creating. In essence, we're doing it backwards, but we're going to fulfill the fact that now we have two members on this board that are in fact part of the Coastal Zone Resource Committee. There was some language that drafted it the other way, and I couldn't be good with that. I don't want the Coastal Zone Resource Committee nominating someone to this board, because again, there's a hierarchy board and a sub board. So it has to be this way. Same thing with the dredge committee. I'm sure we have 15 very active members, very qualified people. We're going to go to them first and say, any of you 15 want to serve on this board? We're going to do it backwards the first time. But in the future, it'll always be laid out in this ordinance that it will be the main committee appointing the members or nominating the members for the subcommittees, because that's the way it has to be separated. And then C basically opens the door for this process to happen again. And if there's any other subcommittees may be established as the need arises and requests consistent with the mission and functions of the Barnstable County Coastal Zone Management Committee. And they'll be under the policies and procedures established by Barnstable County Commissioners, including it not limited to the nomination authority and the terms. So as this new committee decides they want to have new subcommittees, they're going to have to follow the same procedures that we've done with these two that we established in this ordinance. Yeah. I do address the funding and the Cape Cod Commission's certainly participation in this and the Cape Cod Cooperative Extension. The reason why the Cooperative Extension is so involved in this is because of the Woods Hole Sea Grant. So obviously we'll be looking for technical support from them. And then six, we're going to open the door so that this can be included in both or either, or maybe even a portion in both budgets. Because with a new memorandum of understanding that we have, I think we're going to open the door for things like this. Which one is that, five?
Yeah, it just has to be switched over.
Yep. A lot to go over, a lot here.
I have a question after.
Do I have any comments from the staff of the commission? Because I noticed they're here in regards to something that you really don't like or want out or want clarified better, or do you want to just put it out for public comment and bring it back and do it then?
Yeah, I think you know, and I let Heather chime in also, but we're comfortable with the intent and the structure of the ordinance. That I would like an opportunity just to take a deeper look at the language, but I think overall we don't have any issues with it.
I have one question. I don't know if this ordinance is the proper vehicle in it, but should we be defining coast? I know it sounds pretty fundamental, but I actually asked a question of a staff member earlier, and she was as not sure as I was. You know, what defines the coast of Cape Cod? What delineates it? And my question was, is the Cape Cod Canal considered part of the Cape coastal area? And we just went all that shore.
My answer to that one is I stayed away from that because I quite frankly think the term coast is like all-encompassing. I'm going to go the opposite end of the Cape. I think this opens the door for us to actually now start maybe looking at subcommittees for the dam seals too. Because, you know, they do impact our coastline. Yeah. They do impact our waterways. Mm. And it might be that a subcommittee could be come out of this committee just to look at that. And it could even be a subcommittee for short term. It doesn't have to be one that's established for ever. But it could just be a short-term subcommittee to look at a situation.
And you have certain things like, I guess, what is it, Monomoy Island, the feds are taking it over, and I mean, do we, would this body get involved in anything like that?
I think this ordinance opens the door for them to be able to, if they think they want to get involved in it. Or if we want them to get involved in it, yep.
So just a couple of comments.
Do you want to come up for, so you can hear you on the, what do you call it, I'm sorry, but.
So, I'm Heather McElroy.
Thank you, by the way, for your help with this.
No problem.
I keep saying aye, and I didn't take all the credit for it, you've done a lot, I appreciate the commission staff, by the way, because this is.
Happy to help.
I get way too much on my plate.
So, sort of a two-part answer to that question about defining coastal, what is coastal? By calling this the Coastal Zone Management, Barnstable County Coastal Zone Management Committee, I think, you know, Christie raises an important point. There's an overlap with the state's Office of Coastal Zone Management, which has defined all of Cape Cod, coastal resources, all of the upland, as the coastal zone. So there could be a little bit of confusion there when you talk about what is the coastal zone. It's everything on Cape Cod.
Okay.
Every last bit of it. If you want to define coastal based on coastal resources as defined under the Wetlands Protection Act, that's pretty broad also. That includes everything that's, you know, salty wet, including the beaches and the dunes, so the dry.
So we're better off leaving it alone then, I guess, or adopting.
Think about it. No,
I think you might want to think about it.
Yeah.
Definitely.
Yeah, because yeah. Calling
but
it.
But you guys are really the ones we're going to need some input on that from. So we just, I don't like the other name though. So we got to come up with something that.
What? I think that puts that might be the, line. Yeah, in terms of questions about definition and naming. Right. Maybe we
personally,
can find something that's different
like
from the
ability
other, and we can...
To go further, though. I like the ability to be able to say, if a fisheries issue comes up, what better committee to go to than this one to, again, maybe put together a subcommittee to look at a certain situation in a short window of time. We got today they're determining the wind guys, who's going to win the wind thing. One of those proposals is to bring the line here on shore. I've been down that road. I was a member of the Cape Cod Commission when we reviewed the last one. This is, again, having it structured like this, I feel it opens the door for us to say, you know what, we want to throw a quick subcommittee together just to look at that proposal out there to find out how it might impact us here on the Cape. If the person who wins it happens to be the one that's going to bring it on shore and Yarmouth or whatever. So
yeah, Lewis Bay is.
I don't see a bad thing having the broader sense, but I think this is what needs to be discussed. So. Right?
Yep.
All
right.
We'll look to you guys for guidance, though. All right. Today, basically, what I would like to do, though, is because I have had a lot of people that have been asking me for this, I have two motions written, but I'm not going to go for the second one because I know that's we're not ready to do that, and that's to approve it and send it along. But let me read this and see if you guys feel okay with it. I'm looking to move to approve the proposed ordinance 18-, to be numbered, establishing the Barnstable County Coastal Zone Management Committee in its draft form and release to the public for input and agenda at our next available meeting for final action. So this kind of just says that we, the commissioners, are on board with the general language that is draft.
Yeah.
Okay.
Absolutely.
So you're going to move it?
So moved. Yeah.
Second.
Okay. And again, it doesn't hold us to anything. I could change this, say, in establishing the currently named, if you don't feel comfortable, because the name
I
is
I still like the name of it.
I'm okay with the name.
All right, well, we'll just leave it
then. If somebody wants to change it, that's
yes. Okay, option. All those in favor of this? This just releases this to the public? All those in favor?
Aye.
Aye. Okay. Thank you again for the commission staff for helping me with this, and I apologize for some people got this in the middle of the night last night. Just let them know that I was doing my best to work on it, you know.
You need to have an alarm that tells you when to go to bed.
Yeah, well, I was trying to get this done, so.
He does a roost, no, that's yeah. Waking up.
Yeah. All right. We had a situation on the agenda that we had to correct something. I asked Owen to make sure that we had on the agenda the ordinance that was passed at the count, at the assembly. And the original agenda went out, and I think it was the wrong ordinance number. So the corrected agenda corrects it from ordinance 1804 to ordinance 1808. 1808 is the one that we have to vote today. So with that, remind you that this is a supplementary appropriation for the Fire Training Academy. So I'm looking for someone to move ordinance 18-08, previously amended and adopted at the Assembly of Delegates meeting on May 16, 2018, adding to the county's operating budget for fiscal year 2018 by making a supplemental appropriation of $45,000 for the Fire Reserve Training Academy as presented.
So moved.
Second.
It's been moved and seconded. Any questions on this one? This, we've already voted this, actually, to send it over to the Assembly. Just to remind you, this is because we are doing a lot more training than we anticipated, and we have to replenish the funds, but we will be recouping most of these with the fees that we are getting. But because of the budget process, we have to put a little bit more money in the account. So all those in favor?
Aye.
Aye. Okay, thank you. New business not anticipated by chair. I do not have anything. We're going to go to commissioner's actions. Authorizations of filling two vacancies for AmeriCorps. Is there anybody from AmeriCorps here? Could you come up? I have some questions on this myself.
Yeah, they have a conference.
And Jack, sure. Did this go in front of the new hire committee? Or the hire?
No, because these are grant-sponsored positions that are all part of the grant, and we're replacing two retirees. So it's not creating new positions.
Okay.
So we didn't.
That's one question I had. Second question is, we have two people who are stepping down, I guess retiring would be the correct word, and we're looking to fill these two vacancies. And these vacancies won't be filled until August, right?
Yes.
Both people are leaving in mid-August?
Mm-hmm.
Okay. Is there... I still have a problem that this didn't go in front of your committee. I think we should have gotten some. We're kind of making it. You know, the other grant position went in front of the committee.
Yep.
And you know, the part-time one, even the one that we took from HUD and brought over to here, which was kind of, you know, some of these things are, I don't want to say no-brainers, but some of these things need to be done. But I just don't want to get away that I think all these things really should go in front of the committee and we should receive some kind of report.
Okay.
Yeah.
So I'm a little unclear. Like, are these the people that are the coordinators, the people who run the houses? Or?
Yeah, the two house supervisors. That they typically just do 1 year of
okay.
House supervision. So it's something that we do every single year. They come and go.
Right.
I mean, they're just part of the.
We had to do this last year too?
Yep. Every year.
Because I know there was a change in I just don't recall having.
I mean, every once in a while there'll be a house supervisor that stays another year, but generally they just do 1 year.
Yeah. Okay.
I have some requests that I'm going to put forth, but I'm not sure if I should do it through you or just wait till staff gets back because I would really like to have some. I like two things, actually, and I'll do it publicly today and then probably make the request to the department head. But one is it's very confusing as to county funds and federal funds that go into this program for the general public. I mean, I kind of know it because I've been around long enough. But also there is a services match that the county does, like providing housing, for instance. Mm-hmm. I would like an actual breakdown of per member total cost, okay, including the cost for the housing, because if housing costs us something, even though we, you know, own the home and provide the housing, there is a cost value to it, mm-hmm, because obviously we're using that cost value to get the matching federal grants. So if I could have that on a single sheet to kind of make it simple, I'd appreciate it.
Sure. So the value of the housing that's been provided in terms of the in-kind match?
Right.
Okay, I mean, we have that, it's all in the proposal, but we can get it broken out for you.
Yeah.
Essentially,
and then I can just do the division by the number of people.
It's about $500 a member.
For?
A month, $500.
Total cost or just the housing?
The housing.
Yeah, now I want, so I'll, if you can get me those figures, then I can do the math and put it together. I'm trying to get trying to achieve a total cost per member.
Sure.
Both county and federal.
Okay.
So, and I don't want to go too far down this, but again, I feel that it's on the agenda and I can, you know, just ask for questions. Anyhow, I don't want to discuss it, but I just want to ask for questions. And the second thing I would really like a copy of is the actual grant that we are answering, not our answer to them, but if I could have a copy of the federal grant that we are applying for this particular thing. I don't know what else to refer to it as. Program, the federal program?
The AmeriCorps program.
Right, that we're responding to a grant application, I imagine, right?
Oh, so you're looking for the RFP? The actual request for proposals
from them,
the AmeriCorps grant,
right?
From the community, okay.
Not our answer.
From the feds.
I have the answer, but I don't have is what the feds are looking for.
Sure.
So I would like to copy that too.
Okay.
And with that, I have no problem with approving this, because again, but I will say for the record that I want all hires to go in front of the subcommittee from now on. Don't make an assumption that some of them are recurring, and that some of them are grants, and that some of them don't need to.
Okay.
And this time forward, I would like them all. And that's personally one commissioner, but I just think we have the policy in place and we should stick to it.
So, sort of related to what he's saying, so these two positions, they do or they do not go through the normal hiring process that we have? They do.
Okay.
So you put out, you advertise it, and so
yes.
on and so forth, and you put together a committee,
yes.
and like
yes.
that. Okay. And... Okay.
So if someone feels comfortable, I'd be looking for someone to move to authorize and filling the two vacancies of AmeriCorps Cape Cod program supervisors in compliance with the county hiring policy as presented.
So moved.
Second.
It's been moved and seconded. Any problems with that or questions? All those in favor?
Aye.
Aye. Great. Thank you again very
Thank
much.
You.
Appreciate it. Authorization for approval of fiscal year 2018 vacation carryover. Very long list. I was actually going to put this in the motion and I said I'm not going there. So I'm looking for someone to move to authorize the approval of fiscal year 2018 vacation carryover request as submitted by the Human Resource Director and as presented.
So moved with the question.
Second.
It's been seconded. Question. I'll go to Ron first. Question?
All right, so this is just for 2018, right?
Yes.
Yes.
Very long list. It was in your packet. It was almost every employee has a few days they want to move over.
I kind of am hesitant to ask this because I don't want to open up a can of worms, but I did look over the list, and I did see the assembly clerk is in there. So I guess we're okay because we're still in FY18, but this isn't, or I'll just leave it. So for the time being,
Every employee, maybe that will clarify. Every employee that used 2 weeks in FY18 is allowed to carry over vacation.
Yeah. Okay.
If they haven't used 2 weeks vacations, we ask them to carry over to September. If they have used 2 weeks vacations, we allow them to carry over till December.
And then that's it.
That's the understanding.
Okay.
So what we're voting today, all is in coordination with our county policy.
Yes.
Okay. Occasionally, this board has the right to bend that policy, but we don't do it that often, but we have. But this, what's in front of us today, fits in with the policy that we have on record.
Yes.
Excellent.
Okay. Thank you.
Do you have anything?
Well, no, I'm supporting the policy.
Okay. Well, that's why I made that clear.
Yeah.
All right. Let's put it to a vote then. All those in favor?
Aye.
Aye. Okay, thank you, Justine, for doing that. That was a lot of work.
Yeah.
Authorizing the appointment to the Barnstable County Health and Human Services Advisory. I'm looking for someone to move the appointments to the Health and Human Services Advisory Council in accordance with Ordinance 90-16, Section 4.1. 5.2C as presented.
So moved.
Second.
It's been moved and seconded. That's, again, a lengthy, normally when we do appointments, I actually list the names and have the dates, expiration dates. But for those of you at home that have nothing to do and follow us, you can go to our packet and see that this is quite a lengthy group of people. All those in favor?
Aye.
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 Okay. I just have to change this one second. Oh, that's right. Okay, that brings us to D, which is the authorization and execution of a contract. I'm looking for someone to move to authorize the execution of a contract with the Massachusetts Department of Children and Families for a grant to Children's Cove in the amount of $75,400 for a period of July 1st, 2018 through June 30th, 2019 for Sexual Abuse Investigation Network, SANE, initiative as presented.
So moved.
Second.
Been moved and seconded. I don't see anyone here from Children's Cove, but I think this is our normal yearly grant that we get from them.
Yes, this right. is the money that funds the director of the same program's salary,
the same
money
program.
Salary. And okay. it comes every year.
All those in favor?
Aye.
Aye.
Aye. We have an authorization of award of an execution of a contract. I'm looking for, I don't see anybody here from purchasing. Actually, can you do me a favor, Jack? Can I skip this one? Can you go see if Elaine Davis is in and maybe she can come in? Because I have some questions on this one. So for just to hold this for 1 second, I'm going to go down to, is she in?
She's training.
Oh, okay. Then she's not here, so I'm going to go back. This is an award of a contract. But isn't it just an award of a bid, and then next week we're going to have the signing of the contracts? The language on this is a little confusing.
No, I think
and what was in the packet was not a contract, it was a bid award.
Yeah.
But it's...
So why don't we put it off till next week?
Is this the vending contract?
Are you saying no?
An award, you're awarding a contract. A bid award is a process, and then we're approving the bid award for a contract with.
Okay, did we have a contract, Owen? Because I noticed we have the bid award in the packet, but I did not see a contract.
To award and execution of the contract. That's appropriate.
We do not have the actual contract. So.
Okay, so then what I'm going to do, does this need to be signed today, the contract?
No.
Okay, I'm going to change this because I want this to come back for the execution of the contract. And I'm going to change it to we're only authorizing the bid award so that we're acknowledging the fact that this particular individual is going to be awarded the bid and then the execution of the contract is going to have to come back to us.
Really?
So.
I don't.
Why don't we just postpone
no,
it?
We're not, I think we don't do anything with the award.
I mean, he said
we authorize the contract.
No, he didn't say. This is
I don't think. Excuse me, you have to
do one go. Yeah. Why don't you go first? You're the lady.
Go ahead.
Well, I just
ladies
think
first.
That. Oh. what we do, we're executing or approving the execution of
that?
A contract.
Nothing.
A bid award, I don't think is. That's just a process.
You go back
to get
and look,
to a contract.
If you go back and
it's
look
just
at our.
Funny language.
If you go back and look at our agendas,
yeah,
I guarantee you, you will see the first week is the vote to authorize the bid award. And then the second week is the vote to exercise the contract. We've done it 100 times.
Here's where the process was changed a little bit. We've run into situations where the contract, the bids and the contracts run up to a deadline, a service deadline. The contract should have been filed along with the bid, and it could have been both approved today. I don't know why the contract wasn't included. But the idea was to expedite the process to have the bid award and the contract presented to you at the same time so they can be executed the same day.
Okay.
But the contract isn't included in the packet for some reason. I don't know.
So
remember. What it is that the vending company doesn't pay us a huge amount of money. They'll pay us about $3,000 to $5,000 a year, depending on sales, for the vending machines on the campus. The vending machines at the rest of the year are not included in the bid. They're now the responsibility of the Chamber of Commerce.
So is there a deadline that this has to be approved anytime soon? Like
I don't know of that. I don't think
I would rather have Elaine Davis here to specify.
Yeah. Yeah, I would assume it's July 1.
Okay, for the record, too, then.
I would rather have her here in front of us.
The reason why I also am drawing attention to this, and I know it has very little minimal impact as far as money goes to the county, but I buy stuff out of the vending machines, and I am not going to get something that is outdated by 7 months, in some cases even a year. I am not going to have a vending machine in this building that I'm authorizing a contract if I end up getting that again. So I want to make damn sure that when we sign this contract, there's language in there that if somebody gets something out of these vending machines that is outdated by that length of time, these machines will be removed from the property immediately, period. And I'm going to stand by that because I don't need the $3,000. Neither does the county need the $3,000. This is ridiculous, though. You know, you got people that, anyhow, that's why I want that language in the contract. Not seeing the contract, I don't have a problem doing the bid award to this particular individual. Yeah, but I want the contract to specifically state that all items shall be, make sure that they're in the machine and not the time that they're put in, the time that someone can buy them, that they're not outdated. So yeah. With that, I'll put this on next week. And
so no action.
No action.
Okay.
No action for now?
That's fine.
Okay. All right. Authorization execution of a contract with Peterson Oil. This is for fuel delivery. I'm looking for someone to move to authorize the execution of a contract with Peterson Oil for the supply and delivery of fuel oil to Barnstable County and other political subdivisions for the period of July 1st, 2018 through June 30th, 2019 as presented.
So moved.
Second.
Been moved and seconded. All those in favor?
Aye.
Aye. Authorization renewal of contract with Massachusetts Department of Public Health. I'm looking for someone to authorize the renewal of a contract with Massachusetts Department of Public Health for a grant to the Human Resources Department. Bless you twice. In the amount of $200,000 for a period of July 1st, 2018 through June 30th, 2020 for the Substance Abuse Prevention Collaborative Initiative as presented.
So moved.
Second.
Been moved and seconded. We have someone here. Any questions on this?
Mm-mm. Wait a minute. Wait a second. Does this fit in with the substance abuse council that you have? And
yes, this is a renewal of a grant that we have with DPH to fund the SAPSE, which is the Substance Abuse Prevention Collaborative. So it's
and this is totally separate from the commercials, the ads you're doing on the radio, and that's a whole different ballgame, right?
I don't know how to respond to that. So
this funding, that isn't that a different grant that does that?
We use multiple funding sources.
I hate to ask, but just because we got people at home and
I mean, I like your ads on the radio. I'm just wondering. I'm just trying to.
So we use a portion
get
of
the
our,
overall picture.
Yes.
Of it.
So for the My Choice Matter public health education campaign, we use multiple sources of funding. We do use a small amount of our SAPSE grant to pay for some of the costs associated with that campaign. The radio ads that we're running right now are paid for totally out of a separate grant that we secured. But yeah, My Choice Matters is one of the campaigns that we're running under our substance use work.
Thank you.
You're welcome.
Okay, all those in favor?
Aye.
Aye. Okay, authorization of award, execute a contract with W.B. Mason. I'm looking for someone to move to authorize the award and execution of a contract with W.B. Mason. It's a treehouse and Kenmark for the supply and delivery of toner to the county and other political subdivisions for the period of July 1st, 2018 through June 30th, 2019 as presented.
So moved.
Second.
Been moved and seconded. Any questions?
Yeah. Does W.B. Mason have all these contracts for like office supplies and stuff?
They're the only ones that have been responding lately. Because
they got the one to deliver all the paper to all the schools on the Cape too, I remember well.
And the islands.
And the islands too?
Yeah,
they do well.
The discount is dramatic.
Yeah, okay, just curious.
And their service delivery is the best.
So excellent, okay.
That's why they usually get those.
Plus they're the only ones that respond. Yeah.
Okay, all those in favor?
Thank you. Aye.
Aye. Authorization and execution of the documents regarding funding for the Massachusetts Department of Environmental Protection. I'm looking for someone to move to authorize the execution of the documents regarding funding for the Massachusetts Department of Environmental Protection for the fiscal year 2018 water quality monitoring program as presented.
So moved, and then question.
Yep, moved and seconded.
Is this tied in with what we authorized from these?
Yes, this is tied into the water quality committee.
$180,000
that we put up. It appears that, and I did have a question on this, but it appears that the Cape Cod Commission is once again asking for $250,000. And I believe there's a match thing for the state. So we've already given $180,000. I am assuming, and I shouldn't assume, but I'm assuming that the commission is going to probably be making up the balance between the $180,000 and $250,000 with either in-kind services or maybe some cash out of their own reserves, because it is a requirement of the documentation that it's a match. So they also may be coming back before us when we put some more money in the grant account, if we have some available for them, to help them a little bit too. But according to the paperwork I read anyhow, they're looking for the full $250,000, which is the maximum match.
Okay.
So there are members of the commission here if you have any more questions, but did I do you guys justice?
Yep.
I did. I got a thumbs up, so.
That's good.
Okay. All those in favor?
Aye.
Aye. I'm going to keep this if you don't mind, for my records. Mm-hmm. We took Jay out of order, and we've already approved it. For the, if anybody has either joined us via television or has come into the room late, which I don't see anyone, we took Jay out of order because one of our staff members had to leave and wanted to be here for some questions. So the action has already been taken to move to authorize the chair to execute the SF-424 and SF-424D forms. And that's all has to do with the home program 2018 documentations. And we also asked for a presentation of that program. So that will be on our agenda at a later date. That brings us to K, which is an authorization and extension of a subaward agreement with the University of Rhode Island. I'll be looking for someone to move to authorize the extension of a subaward agreement with the University of Rhode Island Department of Resources and Economics, extending the time of performance to August 31st, 2018, as presented.
So moved.
Second.
Is there any questions on this? This has to do with the Cape Cod Commission too, and they are here. Okay, been moved and seconded. All those in favor?
Aye.
Aye. Commissioner's reports. We had a open meeting law training on May 21st. I attended, and a member of the Cape Cod Commission staff attended. Not sure if you guys had anybody else there. I only noticed one. There was about, in attendance was over 30. I'm going to guess closer to 40, actually, because the room was pretty filled. Jack, again, was there from our staff, too. Went very, very well. I was impressed with the fact that we had it here. I believe we did attract some people from Provincetown and certainly from some towns down Cape. So I think it's really important that we continue to have these here. The last one that was on the Cape was in Mashpee, and it does tend to be a little long for you know, people that are driving all the way down from either Orleans or Eastham and Wellfleet. So I'm not really sure where they all came from, but I do remember hearing some people ask questions, and I know that there were members there from Provincetown. I also attended the Fire Training Academy graduation on Saturday. A very, very impressive group of young and, men and women, and a really great service. I want to extend my thanks to the college. We expected some heavy downpours. The rain's kind of held off. It drizzled a little bit, but the venue, the room that they allowed us to use, the cafeteria, was an excellent room for it. And I think that the families of the and friends of the graduates were happy to have it indoors and being able to sit at the table. The only other thing I have run into, being on the campaign trail now, I'm running into our Cape delegation quite a bit. I'm very disappointed, and I want to go on the record as being concerned of the early retirement bill. I think we should probably put it on the agenda next week to discuss it in open session. So Owen, if you can remind me to put that on the agenda for discussion. We have to, as county commissioners, I believe, reach out to all our Cape delegation and find out who we can push this along. But July 1st is coming very quickly. If it does not get passed before July 1st, it may get passed through one of the summer sessions. But if it doesn't get done real soon, it's probably not going to happen until January.
Is that in the committee in third reading right now?
It's already been out of third reading, from what I understand.
It hasn't come out of third.
It's in third reading, which is like the final stage before they vote on it. Yeah.
I put some calls in this morning on that.
Good. Commissioner Beattie, do you have anything?
Yeah, just something I'd like to mention. I've been communicating with Sean, our health department director, to arrange for a tour of the water quality lab, because they're wrapping up a lot of the upgrades and renovations they've been doing, hooking up that new big huge machine and whatnot. So if anybody's interested in getting a tour of that plus everything else they do, maybe you can touch base with him when it's going to be planned for. We're still putting together a date, and I already got some members of the Assembly of Delegates interested that will be taking the tour as well.
Great. Commissioner Flynn?
No.
Other than getting lost today on the way here? Heated discussions? I want to find out what the discussion was about when you drove by the place. Then. Okay. County Administrator.
Well, first, if you'd, you can't see it right now, but if you turned it over your shoulders, you would have seen them working on the statues today.
Yeah.
So that's
great.
A prompt reaction by the facilities director.
I would say.
He's buffing them.
Usually it's 2 weeks, but he did this within a week, so that's pretty good. On the lab, the HVAC system is done. The electrical and plumbing are underway. July 1st is the deadline to have all the construction work done, and then the machine will be retrofitted by the company. And hopefully we'll be in a testing mode by the fall, and we could start our certification process. Also, the HVA system today is underway in the East Wing. And in this afternoon, the engineering report should be into the facility, so we can start the final work on that. I know that I talked to Donnie Reynolds this morning about working with Chrissy on the AV systems to make sure that we're wiring before we put the ceiling in. And he's going to contact Chrissy directly and see if we can't get on the same page there. So East Wing is coming. Route 6 rest area. They had a great cleanup day last Friday. I can't thank the AmeriCorps kids enough for their efforts out there, the AmeriCorps team, I should say.
Young adults.
For their efforts out there. And the members of the Chamber of Commerce from throughout the region showed up to help. The state was actually out there Monday doing the heavy work, cutting grass and shrubs and so on and so forth. So the last step with the flags, the Korean War vets, for obvious reasons, probably won't maintain the monument this year. So we've stepped up. Steve's has got his crew up today doing some trim work out there. The chamber got flags, and the flags are up. Deputy Chief Sonnabend from Bonstable has contacted me, and we're working together to see if we can make this an Eagle Scout project for the summer and have the Boy Scouts maintain the Korean War vet monument that's out there. But it will be clean and ready for this weekend, Memorial Day weekend. So that was just a great effort by everybody. In your packet today, there are really two good presentations that you might want to take out. One is the draft home report that Michelle talked about briefly when she was here. It'll help when you're dealing with the public. It'll help you guys get a more comprehensive review of what's going on in terms of dealing with the homelessness problem.
Well, that's why we're going to have a full
but it's a good one to look. It's a good one to look at, and I bring that up because your packet is so thick this week that's one you might want to pull out. And the Cape Cod Commission did a great package as well on the water quality monitoring program. It's also in there to give you background as you meet the public. And finally, in addition to the Attorney General's open meeting law program on Monday, Elaine ran a regional procurement program here yesterday and was very well attended. So to follow up with what the chairman said, we're trying to do more and more of that with the Constable Connor.
Jack, do I some reason I had in my head that they were having a informational session up at the Harborview tonight at 5:30 in regards to the street way out here. The doing over of the
sidewalks.
Sidewalks.
The Barnstable Village Association contacted Steve about using the building for that, I believe.
Tonight. Is that today, yeah. Tonight, right?
I actually have to check, Leo. I'm not 100%.
Okay, all right. Because I'm going to try to go as a representative of the county, so.
Okay.
Right.
Great. Thank you.
Steve, do you have anything?
Yeah, just quick.
Want to borrow my jacket?
Yeah, pardon my parents. I'm in the field today. Just a quick update on, just a jump on Leo's tailcoat. It's a little, the graduation for the fire academy. It was the biggest class they've graduated out there in, I think they said 15 years. It was 36 cadets, and there was over 300 guests. So the Cape Cod Community College once again stepped up and gave us a perfect venue for all the people that we were expecting to have. Typically what we do at the fire academy is we kind of open up the app bays and then put a tent outside, which the sheriff usually donates to us to use. But even at that, even if the weather was great, it wouldn't have fit. So it actually worked out perfectly. I'd like to thank Commissioner Kakunis and Rep Whalen and Vieira for coming. And Congressman Keating also was there. So it was a really good turnout. And my son was actually one of the graduates this year. So it was really good to see the whole process go through. It was a really nice process. On both sides, from the management aspect of it, and then watching just as a parent be there. So it was a really good process, the whole thing through. That was it. I just wanted to thank Leo and you guys for all your support of it.
You also have a county employee.
Oh, yeah, and actually Parker Kelly, who's actually on the facilities team, was actually another graduate of the academy this year. So it was really good to see. I kind of go, it's from talking to the people in the fire industry. It used to be that. It used to be the DPW workers that were all on the call departments. And now it's kind of full circle again. A lot of them are getting back to it.
Full circle is not the, what do you call it?
Right.
It had to be 20-something years ago, I guess now. I was a stick man for a lady that had a surveying company, you know, young lady, and she was pregnant at the time. And, you know, I'd hold her stick, and one of those summer jobs I had or whatever, trying to make more money down in the cave. He graduated. He was in the graduating class. I'm like, wow, I'm getting old. So she was, when I knew her, I first met his mother, she was pregnant with him. So, and like I said, it had to be 25 years ago, I guess, or 23 years ago.
Wow.
So there was a lot of people in that class that I knew. It was kind of funny.
Yeah, it was really.
I bet you I knew at least six of the graduates, including your son.
Yeah, just in the past 3 years that I've been involved with the fire academy, it's been quite a change. Like the first one I went to, I think there might have been 70 people in the audience, maybe 19, 18 kids graduating. So it's every year it's progressed, and that's, you know, one of the reasons why you guys signed, you know, more money into their budget today. It's a really positive thing. And then just the participation from all the chiefs. I think there was two or three chiefs that didn't have any cadets in the class that actually attended the graduation today. So the support we're getting from the Chiefs Association is really good. So
good.
All positive things.
Good.
Okay.
All right, any other staff members here like to address us or anything, updates? I know there's somebody watching from home that called last week and complained that my chair was squeaking. I just want to let you know, I put WD-40 on it, but it still squeaks a little bit, so. Hear it?
Yeah.
Sorry.
Are
we going to get new chairs?
No, we don't need new chairs.
I'm just
These
kidding.
Are fine. Okay, motion to adjourn then.
So moved.
Second.
Moved and seconded. All those in favor?
Aye.
Aye.
Thank you.